Hey friends, it's Allie with Allie Oops Boutique and AllieOopsMarketHouseDIY.com. Today in this video, you're going to see my absolute favorite technique in creating an authentic looking Chippy paint finish. Now, this technique, you only need a couple of things, and it's going to give you the look of a piece of furniture or item that's been out in your grandma's shed, that's had layers of paint on it, it's chipping and wearing over time because of the elements, and it looks so naturally worn. And that's what you're gonna get in just a couple of steps today on anything you wanna do, home decor, cabinets, furniture, whatever. All you're gonna need is some paint. I'm using Rethunk Junk by Laura paint, which is a resin paint, and it's absolutely perfect for this project. You can also use any chalk paint. I've used chalk paint in the past, and it's worked really well. And then you're gonna need some petroleum jelly. So I've got Vaseline, but it doesn't matter what petroleum jelly you use, just get you some petroleum jelly. Then of course you're gonna need all your brushes and your things that you need when you paint. But to do this, you really only need two products. It's gonna be your paint and petroleum jelly. So now get ready to see my favorite way to create an authentic looking Chippy paint finish. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I just primed this cabinet door. And I'm going to put a couple of different colors of green. I've got Eucalyptus by Rethunk Junk and I've got Seaside. And the reason I do that is so that when it chips off and we do a little bit of the distressing, it looks as if this has just layered coats of old paint. So I'm shaking up the paint really well. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of this color, beautiful eucalyptus. Gonna put a little bit here on the corner. And there's no rhyme or reason. You literally want this to look like a three-year-old did it. Like my little grandson came out here and said, "Let me help you, Gaga, with your painting." And he got a hold of the brush. That's what you want it to look like. You just wanna hit it in different spots. You're not going for full coverage. You just want to hit it because I'm gonna do the Chippy technique on the corners, maybe a little bit on the front, but just where it would naturally start to chip over time. So now I'm gonna take a lighter green blue called Seaside by Rethunk Junk. I actually love this color. And well, I love both of them, but this one, one of my favorites. And I'm just going to do my paint here and there. So I'm going to move this so you can see what I'm doing. All right, so that is what you want your first coat to look like when you're getting ready to do the Chippy paste, so, or Chippy technique. So we're going to let this dry. Then we'll come back in just a little bit and I'll show you the magic, how to make the magic happen. Okay, so now I have let my paint dry. So the next step is, once this is all dry, and you can use any colors you want, is to take some petroleum jelly, it doesn't matter what brand, and you're going to want to put the jelly on in areas that would naturally over time get wear. I like authentic looking distressing. That's my preference. Some people like it just all over willy-nilly, but I like to take my time and think about where would it have naturally worn over time. So that's typically gonna be the corners, the edges, and maybe a little bit around where a handle would be, maybe a little bit on the front where they might have cleaned it, but it's primarily gonna be around these edges. So you're gonna take your petroleum jelly and you can put it on however you like. You can use your finger and just spread a little on. And this is great because you can kind of see what colors are gonna show through at this stage. Now, if you don't want to get, now I always love this part because it always, after the fact, I put it on my cuticles and it makes my hands feel real smooth. But if you don't like that feeling, I know texture is a thing for people, you can put a little bit on your palette knife and just put a little bit on here and there. I'm just going to put on the corners, the edges, as I said. I've done, I'll point it out, I've done the edges, the corners, a little bit in the front, so you'll see a little bit of the different colors coming through, and I put some on with my finger, I put some on with a palette knife, however you want to put it on. You don't have to put a lot, but it's going to give the most authentic looking Chippy. I see another area I want to put a little bit more jelly. You can use the palette knife method and put a little bit like right in here. Now you don't want to get, if you've got a lot of grooves or details, you probably don't want to do too much in those. Don't get it in, it's kind of hard to get out of those cracks. So you may want to be careful not to do too much in your cracks. Okay, now I'm going to put the top coat on. And the top coat I'm using today, this is Snowy Day by Refunk Junk Paint by Laura. So I'm going to just take my paint, paint right over that petroleum jelly, just like you were painting your top coat. And you probably, I'm dipping into my jar, which I probably shouldn't do. This, you probably want to put your paint in another container so you don't contaminate it, because if that petroleum jelly gets in your paint, it's not a good thing. So don't do as I do on that one. So I'm going to do one coat. Now, if you're familiar with Refunk Junk, your first coat's usually a really ugly coat, they like to say. It's not pretty. You just get the paint on there. And then the second coat is where the beauty really starts to show. And you get really good coverage. And in most cases with Refunk Junk paint, you know, you're only gonna need two coats, sometimes three. But they're typically, you wanna do light coats. So you're really still not using a ton of paint. Now these cabinet doors I'm using for this demo, but what I've been doing as of late, I had extra cabinet doors laying around for some other demos that we did. So lately I've been using them for trays. All right, so I just put a layer of paint. And you can kind of see where that petroleum jelly is not wanting that paint to sit on it. And that's fine. That's exactly what you want. Okay. Now, because I'm going for a chippy look, I could just leave this at this amount of coverage. But I'm probably going to go back in and do a second coat just so I can truly show y'all what a good chippy finish might look like. So we're going to let this dry. It's a little humid out here today, so it might take a minute, but I'll be back and show you the next step. All right, second coat before the rain rolls in. Let's watch the magic happen. Everything's completely dry. I've got some sanding, a sanding sponge. I'll have to put in the description what grit this is, but it is a medium, like a coarse medium sandpaper. So let's get started. Look at that paint just immediately chipping off like it has been worn for years. And now I can kind of see where I put, you see that? I put the petroleum jelly, but some of it you can't see. So it's really good to just give your piece this light. You really don't have to put too much effort into it. A little sanding all over. Now, some people use a rotary sander to do this, and that's not necessary for what I'm doing, but you certainly, I guess, could. So I have this really cool, authentic looking chipping around the edges and a little bit, and they're different colors. So that's what makes it so cool. All right, I especially love this area in here. I love the blue on the side. Let's see, oh, is that where the handle would have been? I mudded my, no, right here. So yes, that makes sense that the handle would have gone up here. So you're going to get a lot of wear and tear around your bottom of your cabinet. So anyway, this is looking really good. I'm going to keep working on it and then I will show you my finished product.